electrical system offline. Multiple system failure. Caution. Caution. Fire in section C.
Hey, goddamn, I ain't never seen anything like that before.
I knew he saved you for a reason.
Hey, you gave us something back we thought we'd never have again. Hope. Whatever happens next, we're with you.
Hey. That was a hell of a job, Brooke. The way I see it, you're the one in charge now. And if you ever need anything, just let me know.
A seal has been opened. My brother John was loved by few. Feared by many. Misunderstood by all. Except me. John was not born a monster. He was just a child when our family was torn apart. He was loving, kind, and full of joy. He was easily preyed upon. John was not perfect. And sometimes he was not even good. But he was my brother. And those responsible for his death will be punished. I promise you that.
job, Deputy. You just did some serious damage to the cult's firepower. I'm talking irreversible. Cult's gonna be a lot more careful knowing they've been neutered. That ought to help the resistance. Way to show them. Mabel.
Anything. Get. Get out of here! right on. I thought I was a dead man. I think my life left.
Hello? This is Ms. Mabel.
Some help. Took you long enough. Those miserable shits raided my place trying to kill my Peaches. Now she's raced off for her revenge. If I know Peaches, she's gone off to chow down on those hippies. She's probably lounging at the nearby campsite. It smells like armpits and processed meat down there. So those Eden Project losers can't be far away. Go on and find her now. Be sure to take her treats with you. She's just like that little drubbing whore at the marina. She'll follow you anywhere if you give her a treat. Now go get my kitty back.
Found the heretic again!
Hello?
your cage when you have an upset stomach from eating hippie.
I'll be honest. I figured I'd never see you again. Thought you were a little dim in the headlights, but you've proved me wrong. Ah, hell. Why don't you just keep the damn cat? I've enjoyed not having to deal with her incessant needs for food and water and attention the last few days. All right, off you go. We're done here. I'm alive, no thanks to you.
Thank you.
in the big city.
You'll need to get clever with supplies. These Peggy bozos don't know who they're...
Thanks, I thought... Where's my bag? Oh, where is it? Oh, shit! Shit! Shit!
Thank you for saving me. My name is Dr. Charles Lindsay. I'm part of a group holed up south of here at the old jail. Faith and her angels have been trying to get to us for days. I was out here looking for a way to stop them when the cult took me. I think I found a way to bait the angels, but the ingredients for the bait are in my bag and the cult threw it in the pond. And I can't swim. I know who can't swim, but I need you to go get it for me. saved all our lives. Seriously. Sorry, my name's Charles. Everyone calls me Doc, but I'm not that kind of doctor. I'm a veterinarian. But right now, I guess I'm the resident ER doctor. Stitching up bullet wounds is a lot different than delivering cabs, that's for goddamn sure. Sorry, doesn't matter. Here's the deal. I stumbled on something that seems to attract the angels, which means we could herd them. I went out to try a field test, but things went sideways. Fucking cult. I'm missing ingredients, and if I stay out here, I'm just gonna wind up dead. I have to get back to the prison. Can you help me? I've got the list of stuff I still need. If you could find them, we may actually have a chance at surviving. Your jail defense was amazing.
Sometimes I wonder how much more of this fighting I can stomach. Remind you that we shouldn't be living our whole entire life like this.
You've been invited into our home, into our heart. Trust in the path and you'll find the answers you seek. Even those who fight against us seek salvation. You're proof of that. We all need guidance in times like these.
So we must be strong. We must be vigilant.
Now you'll see. Now you'll truly understand.
Because those on the outside will see what we have built here together in our new Eden. Love. And they will come. And they will try to take from us all that we have built. You judge me. You judge us. The things that we have done. People say that I'm crazy. But when you wake up in the morning, you look at the same news that I do.
This is the world? This is the world we built for our children? Communities being torn apart? Walls being erected? Because leaders are too impotent to act. Bullies are too adult to lead righteously. Towards our destruction, and no one is willing to do anything about it. I can see that. You can see. But we are not crazy. So what are we supposed to do? We just sit back and await the inevitable?
I claim to be a perfect man. But I saw what was coming, and I chose to act. To lead, because society is broken. And the only way forward is to go back to the way things once were. Innocent and pure, so safe and protected in our garden. I can save you.
Jesus Christ, you scared the shit out of us.
Hey, Sheriff. Couple didn't make it back. Boy said...
Anybody grab Burke?
Grady, supposedly, but...
Well, where the hell's Grady?
Ah, Jesus. Now, you just relax. Lie back. I'll see you in the morning.
You come out of the bliss too fast. Shit's liable to scramble your fucking brains.
Glad to see you, pal.
I've had to improvise most of my lab supplies. I put my shoe liners together. How do, Missy?
How you making out, cowboy?
I thought we lost you to that bliss, deputy. Thank God for that sheriff of yours. See what you can do to help these folks out.
Be careful.
Excuse me, I... just, having a moment. Deputy, I need to ask you something. You ever heard of a fella by the name of Feeney? He was a pharmacist in town. A lot of people looked up to him. Thought he was a pillar of the community, but, truth is, he was nothing but a dope pusher. Feeney's with the cult now. Helped him create this... bliss. Word is, he's up at Jessup Conservatory. It was a beautiful atrium back before... well, before. Now Feeney's using it to grow his poison. Nothing but fields of those awful flowers. So, I was thinking, if you happen to head over there and burn them flowers, well, I bet Feeney'd come running over in a panic.
I think Sheriff Whitehorse thinks of himself as your dad.
Afraid to fight in the dark.
Our red mountain lions could see real...